Hi guys, this is Foolie. Today I am going to show you guys how to create a custom login page in your WordPress website.
All right, let's log into your dashboard on your website. Enter your username or email address here. And then enter your password next. Don't forget to click Remember Me if you want your browser to remember your username, and then click Log In. Go to Plugins and click Plugins. Click Add New on the top of the page. Type LoginPress in the search box. That's the plugin that we are going to use. It has so many downloads and ratings. Click Install now. And then click the Activate button once done. Hover over the Appearance menu on the left panel to select LoginPress. These are the settings of the LoginPress plugin. Click Logo. Click Select Image to upload or select a logo for your login form on the login page. This is the logo that I'm gonna use. And click Choose Image at the bottom right. And that's the logo on the form. Next, right here, you could modify your logo URL. I need to add the S in the URL because we have installed an SSL certificate for this demo store or demo website. And then the logo title, when somebody hover over the logo, they will be to see this text if they using their desktop to access your website. That's the login page title that will appear on a browser tab. You could leave it as it is. You don't have to worry about it. Once everything looks good, just click the publish button on the top. Let's go back to the main section. Let's click background right here. Here are the free background images that you could choose for free or you could use for free. Let's pick this one. If you have your own image, you could use the button below to select your own image. If you want to upload your own image, just click the button right here, select image, and then you can upload your own image. Let's get out of here. The section below is for the background image, repeat, position, and size settings that you could play around with them or just leave them alone if you're happy with the result so far. The section underneath it is for the video background that you could enable if you want to. Once everything looks good, just click the publish button on the top of the page. Alright, it looks good so far. Let's go back to the main settings to go to the next section. Next, we are going to click Customize Login Form. You could play around with all these settings if you want to, and let's see how your form will look like. But if you don't want to waste your time or worry about it, you could leave it as it is, as a clean design. So the next, let's go to Customize Forget Form. Click Customize Forget Form. In this section, if you want to play around or add a background image for it, specifically, it's up to you. Just click the button and then just choose whatever. But if you're happy with the default design, just click out. All right, let's click out of the media library. So let's go to the next section, which is reCAPTCHA. So as for the reCAPTCHA section, this one is for the paid version or for the premium feature only. So we don't have to worry about that because we don't want to pay for that. And the next one is for button beauty. Click button beauty. Well, this section is to change the color of your login button right there. This is my color palette that I'm gonna use to change the color of my login button. So I'm gonna use the blue and I'm gonna type my hex code right here directly. Once that's done, I'm gonna copy this blue hex code to the next one for the border of the button. Click in that box and type your hex code directly and click out. And then copy the same hex code for your button border color will be matching with the color of the button. Then click the button border color box at the bottom to paste the same blue hex code to it. You should be able to see the changes on the right panel right away. And the next color is for when you hover over like that. I want the button to change color to yellow when we hover over it. So I need to go back to my color palette to copy the hex code real quick. And that's the yellow that I want to use for my hover over color. And click right there. And then enter your hex code right here. Once I get this hex color code right here, I'm going to copy it. And to paste it right here, that's for the border of the button. And right there. Now the text login looks a little bit too bright and not really visible. So as to the color palette, the text should be the black color. Click button text color and select black. It should be 000, 60. And then at the bottom, click that too for the hover text color to black too. And you should be able to see the text as login of that button turns to black. And it's more visible that way. And the next section right below it is for some other settings that you could play around. For example, like that one is for the padding to add extra space all around the login wording. Once everything looks good, just click the publish button on the top of the page. And let's click on these little icons at the bottom to see different views. Like this one for the tablet preview, and this one is for the mobile version. That's how it's gonna look like when you view it on your mobile phone. And then you could scroll up and down, and then it's gonna still look like that. That one is the tablet version. And let's get back to the desktop version. All right, let's click here to get out of here. The next section is for error messages. And then you could go through all the messages right here if you have that time. If not, just ignore this section because the default messages from them are pretty good already. As for welcome messages, if you want to change something, just click into one of those boxes and just change and click on the publish button. All right, next, let's go to form footer. As for this section, it is for the bottom section of the login form. There are a bunch of links down there. You don't have to worry about this section at all. Just leave it as it is, as the default settings, because it's already good. But make sure you enable the back to links so the users could get back to the homepage if they don't want to log in to the dashboard or the backend or something like that. I also want to add the copyright at the footer at the bottom of the page too. Here's how you add it. You add it in this box, and I'm gonna change this name to Doodling Demos real quick. You could add whatever you want. It should be your company's name or the website name right there. And make sure you enable that toggle button to enable the footer. And as you could see the footer right there at the bottom of the login page. Once everything looks good, just click the publish button. Well, before we get out of this section, let's take a look at different versions of different devices for this login page to see how it's gonna look like. So far, so good. And then next, let's go to Google Fonts. Well, for this section, it's for the premium feature only, so you don't have to worry about this section. Just get out of here. As for the last section, which is the custom CSS and JS, it's for the users who know how to write those scripts to customize the login form. So you don't have to worry about this section at all unless you want to try to do some light coding. All right, let's log out so we could check out the login page. Hover over the username and click log out. Here you go, the customized login page.